Hey, George. You're doing a damn fine job there, boy. Keep doing what you're doing. Getting me lots and lots of wood. Haha. Hey, guys. Welcome back to episode 4 of Vioki Plays Feed the Beast on the OcelotInc server. Server owner's online today. That's Sironita. I don't know if I'm pronouncing that right. Certainly seems to be spelt that way. So yeah, check this out. I've got the tree farm working properly. We've got these transposer things from Red Power. Let's just break this one off. Oh, careful. Transposer. And these things basically just suck up all the saplings. So any saplings that drop down, they will suck them up. Just like, oh, you can see one there. Gone sapling. It's gone. It's gone. And so that gets sucked up and put into this chest. And if that's full up, it'll go to this barrel. And you can see it's working very well. That's actually all my saplings. I moved this, the ones I had in my house out to here. So that's all my saplings. And this is most of my wood. I have another barrel completely full up over there in the house. Ah! Good. So yeah, this is George, and he's doing a damn good job chopping down trees. And he does it very, very well now. He keeps his bone meal there and his saplings there. And if he gets low on them, he comes and restocks from these chests. And then he just plants the tree, grows it, drops it down, and I've got him on a 2-minute wait timer before he does another one. So, that's awesome. And this is all thanks to Virez on the server. He's not online at the moment. He was online earlier, and he helped me get all this, helped me figure out a lot of this stuff. Like, these transposer things, I didn't know how to use these. So he helped a lot. So yeah, that's going good. And the reason I'm getting this all done is because if you come over here, you can see how the excavation is going. Not very well yet. This is how much they managed to do, my four turtles, with two stacks of charcoal each. Two stacks of charcoal worth of fuel. That's how much they managed to clear out, down to ground level, basically. So not very much. So I've been gathering tons of charcoal so I can get this thing running and leave it running until it gets all the way down to bedrock. And I've been doing that for a while, and I'm finally about there, I think. I think I have enough now. Oh, and I've made another turtle since George is busy chopping down trees. One of these guys, I think it's this one. Yep, there's Vimes. He's the new guy. He's red. Oh, I needed these placed here. Whoops. Where's he gone? I need these guys placed. Because I need to refuel them. Check it out. Complete for the... Oh, I'm missing a stack of logs. No, I'm missing one log. Anyway, completely full up barrel of charcoal. And we're going to put that entire 64 stacks into these guys and refuel them and then have them excavating away. Did I pick all that up? That's 14. 16. Each of these will hold 16 in their inventory. Excuse me. I actually worked out a little bit of maths. I worked out it would probably take about 11 stacks to excavate a 30 by 30. 11 stacks of charcoal. But that's without including the amount of fuel it uses to go up to the chest and place all its stuff every time it gets full up. So I'm hoping 16 stacks will be enough. 16 stacks of fuel for each turtle. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Aha! So let's get these guys going and start with the bee stuff, because that's what we're going to be doing today. Oops, I went over a little bit there. No, I didn't. That's 16. So I should have 16 stacks left. Feeding my turtles. That's what we're doing. Feeding them up nice and fat. And they're going to give us lots of stuff. So, refuel. Whoa. So you just go through and eat everything. Aha. Oops, see daisy. So, Ulti is online. She's pretty awesome. She was the one causing all the damn thunder in episode 1, apparently. With her damn thunder bees. Ugh. Hate them. What's the point? Okay, so these guys have 81,000 moves in them. Let's go get them set up again. Because 2 stacks was clearly not enough fuel. Oh, and I moved the chest down here so that they actually start at ground level now. Which will be good. Boom. Oh, what was I saying about George? He actually refuels himself from the logs that he chops down. So I don't have to worry about him. So, excavate 30, go! Aha! Oh, and I better get that warmed up too. That needs to go fast or else it's going to have too many items going in there. Of course, what I could do is set up an ender chest here, and then have the other side of the ender chest having the item sucked out through filters. Well, actually, what I could do is just have a filter going into it and use the red power tubes to send power to them, because I'm a little bit better experienced with red power now. I might actually be able to do it. You know what, I should have started them off on the layer lower. That's a bit of a waste of fuel. Never mind. Something else Virez did for us, or me, when he was here helping me. He took me to his base and showed me around. It's actually pretty close by. I didn't mark it down, but it's only about 800 blocks from my base. He gave me a load of bones, some enderpearls, some slime balls, and blaze rods, which I need. Because I need to start getting steel so I can upgrade my tools and stuff, and I need the blaze rods so I can get steel. Anyway, there's George going, doing his thing. He's doing a good job. The reason he waits 2 minutes is so the saplings have plenty of chance to fall down, because I'm going to start using these to make, what is it, biomass. That's what I want to use them for. I need to add another barrel there before I start with the bees. Just smelting some charcoal here. Because I just used all of my charcoal up. And I might need some more. Anyway. Barrel. Tube. And I don't know, but I think I need to add an iron ingot. Where's all my iron gone? I put it in the chest downstairs. Chest down here should have iron. Okay, let us begin with the bee stuff. This kind of pipe is a restriction pipe, and according to Vera's, it makes it so stuff will go here last. So, because of the way I've got it going to this chest first, because I want to keep that full up so George can always pick up more saplings if he needs them. Oh, you're not meant to go into there. Where did you get that from? I don't know where that bone meal came from. I guess George must have had an extra one in there when he tried to pick it up or something. I don't know. Oh, who cares? Anyway, that's good. So plenty of saplings. You have to with these fir ones, you can't turn them straight into biomass. You have to turn them into plant balls first, and then the plant balls into biomass. Damn, cobblestone. There we go. Ah, guys, I just logged in today, and check it out. Some lovely person has brought me my cows back. Must have seen my video and took pity on me. Oh, how nice. I was going to go get my own cows, but thing is, I forgot to mention earlier on in this episode, but I died. And I lost my portal gun, so I couldn't go and bring some cows home. I was planning on doing it. But yeah, I died really badly, and I lost my diamond pickaxe, and I lost my longfall boots, so I had to make another pair, which was really bad. It was a really, it was a really silly death. I kind of deserved it. I died in lava in the nether, and yeah. But yeah, this is lovely, so whoever did this, thank you. I don't know who it was yet. Did they leave a sign? I don't think they left a sign. Excavation. We'll talk about that in a sec. And bees. So I was meant to be starting with bees today, or actually yesterday when I recorded the first half of this episode, but I ran into some problems. Let's talk about the excavation first. I had the guys going, and I logged off for a few hours thinking it would be okay to leave it, but I must have logged off for way too long because it's full up. It got full up way too quickly. Everything's full. Cobblestone's pretty much full. Dirt's all full. All these chests are full up. So yeah, that's kind of terrible. And when I came on, the guys, these little turtle guys, were just running around. They were going back and forth between the chest and excavating. And they're all confused because they're all full up of all their inventories were full up. And so they wasted so much of their fuel just going back and forth. So I'm going to have to restock on charcoal again before I can start them up. I didn't realise it was going to be that quick. And the other problem I've been running into with the bees... Oh, I had the same problem with this as well. When I came back online and found the excavation going wrong. George here had, I don't know how it happened, but he had ended up back here, and he was just stuck. So, I don't know how that happened. The bee stuff, though, I've been looking at it, and I realised... Oh, I'm not really prepared yet to do anything with bees. Except, you know, just have them breeding. Because I need all these damn machines that I kind of forgot about, like the centrifuge. You need this to take the items out of the to get the honey out of the honeycombs, and you need a carpenter to make it like all the carpenter. Yep, carpenter, which is made with bronze. Lots of bronze to make the bee-alyzers, just so I can see what these bees are, so you can analyze your bees and see what they are, and also the database for the bees as well. I need one of those, and I need a squeezer to get seed oil so I can make stuff that needs seed oil in the carpenter. So I'm not really prepared for that yet, because all of the machines require MJ power, which I don't have any of yet, but I'm thinking of When I turn this into biomass, I can then turn that into MJ power. So I may do that. And what else? So yeah, I've just been running into lots of problems, and I recorded a lot yesterday and decided I didn't like any of it, so I scrapped most of it. So I just got that 10 minutes for the start of this episode. But yeah, I don't think we're going to manage to do anything with bees today, but hopefully we can figure out how to get this biomass stuff. And then we can start with bees next time. So, biogas engines, they run off biogas. That's what you use to turn the biogas, or biomass. Yep, that's it. Turn this green stuff into MJ power. So I'm going to need to make these. It's all bronze as well, which means I have to use all my copper up, and I don't have much copper. I think that's all the copper I've got. 29 left. There may be some in my excavation. Let's go check. Why's that not loading? World's not loading very well today. Funny. Excavation. Copper. There's a little bit. That must be all of it, right? No, there's... Oh, I've got lots. Got iron. Oh, I knew this excavation was going to go well. Where'd these come from? Oh, I dumped all my stuff in the chest. Gold? Yep, that's just my stuff I dumped. More copper. That's good. And you know what? This computer's been running non-stop doing this ticker. That lever disables the clock. I need to sort all this stuff out. So bad. So yeah, before we can start the excavation going again, I need to get tons more charcoal and set up a big storage room. So I can just dump everything in there. Which is annoying. I should have planned ahead. My cows. I love it. I can make a pouch now, can't I? Oh. Let me see. I don't know what I did with all that stuff I had. I think I put it all in this chest over here. There's a chest there which I had to dump a load of stuff in as well, so that's got some stuff in it. What did I do with it? I know I dumped all my stuff in a chest somewhere. Might have been this one down here. Copper. Ah, there we go. Blaze powder and wool. And an end pole. I think that's everything. So I can have a pouch. I wanted to make this earlier on, but I didn't, so... How does it go? Like this? Nuts. And a pouch. Oh, 4 blaze powder. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. What's the wall in the middle or the ender pearl? There we go. And you link this to the different coloured ender chests. So let's link it to our one. Our black and purple. Oh, purple and black. Purple, black, yellow. So that is now linked, and I can access it from anywhere. Which is awesome! And if I make another ender chest and put it in my base, I can just dump everything in there, or keep valuable things in there, and take it out whenever I need it. So that's useful. Okay, let me look up how to make biomass. I don't know what the machine is called. I need to check. Okay, I checked, and you need a fermenter, so it looks like even more bronze involved. which means I need some of my tin. Where's all my tin gone? I've gone and put it somewhere. Silly me. And I'll get another stack of copper going. Gonna need it all probably. Okay, so you take the tin and you take the copper and you turn it into bronze like this. Doesn't look like the same kind of bronze as in forestry. Anyway, let's look up the fermenter. So, four bronze gears, which are made by upgrading stone gears into bronze ones, and eight more bronze for that, and some glass. So it's pretty easy. The problem's going to be powering it. I'll have to make biomass to power the thing to make biomass. No, I'm going to have to make some kind of a Stirling engine or something. Something that can be powered on coal so that I can get it started. So, stone. I need cobblestone, that's downstairs. And I need wood. Lots of wood, thank you. So to make the gears, I think that's enough. Should be four wooden gears first, and then you upgrade the wooden ones to stone, like that. This is buildcraft stuff. And then to bronze, need more of that. Tin. Okay, so that makes two, does it? That's 1, 2, 3, 4. So there's the gears I need. And then I need another... Don't have enough. Don't have enough copper. Ah. Okay, we can make a fermenter. I didn't want to do too much crafting, but... Oh, sorry. Start with the bronze casing. What's it called? Sturdy casing. So, I can finally start turning things into biomass. So, like I said, I need a engine that will run off coal to get this started. And to make the buildcraft engines, how do you do it? I know how to make the wooden ones. I'm not sure how to make these other ones. I think it's called Stirling engine. Alright, it's the same as the wooden one but with stone. Thought so. So I need some iron. Ah! It's all gone again. I think this episode is going to end up very kind of thrown together and not really very organised. Unfortunately. Okay, so first you make a piston and then we upgrade it to like this. Two stone gears. Boom. Stone gears, piston, glass, and stone. Okay, I think we're ready. Just need a lever to get this thing going. I don't know how much this power this produces. Probably not very much, but hopefully it's enough to get this thing going. To get it started. So let's put it down here. Now where do you feed stuff in? There, that's connected. I have some coal. Should do. Yep. Excellent. So, I I think you need to feed this thing water as well. It needs water in here. And let's get the couple of these going. 32 plant balls. Okay, so they go in the top. Do you need something else in here to make it ferment? I know you need water. And this is where the biomass comes out. Can I feed it water with a bucket? I can. Get it started. Aha! You make compost by putting wheat around dirt, or you can use ash. Okay, I think I've had some wheat laying around somewhere. And I have dirt. This probably isn't going to make very much, by the way, until I get a proper farm set up. I just want to get it started so I can, you know, play a little bit with the bees. Wheat, wheat, wheat. I know I have some wheat somewhere. I have some in the garden I can pick. No. Here we go. Let's clear some of this junk as well while I'm here. Okay. Let's try again. So I'm just going to feed it water manually while I'm testing it. I'll set up a pipe thing with to get proper amounts of water in it. So how much biomass will that produce? Oh, you don't need much compost. It's making it. It's made some. It's used all the stored energy it stored from this engine to make that, to do how much it just did. And now it's going to do it very slowly, because this is not enough power. But once I've produced some biomass, I can make one of those biomass engines with the bronze. So, let's have a look at that. Sorry, biogas engines, isn't it? Yep, bronze to make the engine, and then I think you have to feed it lava and bio, either biomass or biofuel, to make it go. Oh, it's almost made a bucket. Let me get some water. Water, water, water. So I guess bee stuff is put on hold until further notice. I need to make lots more of this stuff. Okay, it's not going as slowly as I thought it would. Okay, I successfully managed to make a biogas engine. This may speed this thing up. Actually, it's not going terribly slow. I don't mind waiting for it. Okay, so get this thing going, you need lava, and, oh, yep, there we go, bucket of bio stuff. So, lava in one slot, biomass in the other, it has to heat up, and now it starts pumping, and that should speed that up a lot. Let's pull some buckets in there. Oops, no. Put them in that slot, please. It does go through the plant balls quickly, doesn't go through the compost too fast. So that's good. I really just need to sort out a big farm. We'll have to have a wheat farm, we'll have to have a dirt farm, I suppose, to get dirt. Actually, instead of compost, you can use this stuff called mulch. I don't know how to get that. I looked it up and it didn't have a recipe in here. So I'll look up how to make that. It might be easier, I don't know. But I need some way of producing something to go in here. And I need to set up pipes to pipe these saplings into a crafting table to turn them into a plant balls and then pump them straight into the fermenter. But yeah, so I think this stuff, we're getting started at least. And once I've started with this, I can make the machines to start doing some bees. Oh, meadows. Oh, I wonder why it doesn't stack, because they should be the same. They're both drones, and I've only used purebred bees. So that's a bit confusing. At least I think they're purebred bees. If you get them from the hive, I thought they were always purebred. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe the hives can sometimes have mutated bees come out of them. Yeah. Energy production has begun. And we'll see how we get along next episode. I'm going to have to do a lot between this episode and next one. Like, there's a lot of stuff I need to do before I can really record again. Ooh. Creepers die. So I guess I'll see you guys later. It was a matter of time.